Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, for me, this is the point, the end point of a really moving and very interesting journey through various aspects of human life related to information. We started this journey with description of case studies of atrocities, of repression. We have learned that Greece, for example, can be seen as a mirror for our own future in other countries of the European Union. We have seen what is going on in a country where democracy started, in the UK, where very valuable newspapers are really under pressure from government and from parliamentary areas. And this is really looking very bad. On the other hand, we have dealt with problems. Journalists are exposed if they try to keep up the freedom of the media and to report truly and freely about the situation as it is. In another panel, we had discussions on alternative ways of having access to information and knowledge. We have seen very good examples, useful examples, on the level of libraries, of archives, and also on the level of universities, which is very valuable knowledge for society. And all these examples were mixed with acts of resistance. It was a testimony that this world, as it is now, may be and could be changed and will be changed. And saying this, I have also to confess that our conference would not have been possible with such acts of resistance which are supported by solidarity. So to start with, I will thank to the interpreters. And I have to tell you a secret. The interpreters have reduced their own salary to help us to make this conference possible. And I think this is really a testimony. Secondly, I would also thank our sponsors and partners, as this is necessary and useful at the end of a conference. You see all the logos and roll-ups here. I learned for my first time in life what is a roll-up, but now I know. And thirdly, I think once again an act of solidarity was the group Solidarity for All, who assisted us in all these organizational issues. And once again, I have to tell you, many people down at the reception were relatives of us, so friends, partners, daughters-in-law, etc., etc. So in this way, we could manage and could organize this conference. So just to be aware, acts of solidarity will help, and I think they will create and produce, earlier or later, a better world. So not to forget that we can do also activities after this conference, I have two proposals. And the first one is a kind of exercise Minas Samatas has done yesterday in the spare leisure time, in his spare leisure time, and he has drafted a kind of declaration of freedom of information of Vienna 2014. I think we are all exhausted at this moment, but we will discuss this in detail. Professor Samatas has agreed that we will condense it and will manage a better content or a condensed content than it is now. And we will send it to you via the internet and will ask you if you would like to sign or if you would like to distribute it all over your other contacts and lists so that we can really have a result where we jointly act. This was one, and second, of course, university on my side, the venue here, Vienna University of Technology, the other. we have the obligation to do publications. So we have already contacted our fund for science and research in Vienna, and they will, with very high probability, they will support us for proceedings of this conference. And also, maybe there is the one or the other journal where we could publish these articles. And I think you will be also addressed in the near future to send your contributions to our editor. And if you like, we could have a book within a few months. We could have published it. We will see. So let me thank again. We go on striving for a better world. Thanks a lot. Don't forget.